Oecophylla smaragdina, weaver ant.
Hello, I'm Nash Turley. So I want to tell you about an experience I had a couple months ago in Thailand. I was walking around a Buddhist temple, and there was lots of vegetation around. There was this small shrub about this high. There were a bunch of ants crawling around on it. And when I walked up close, I got so excited because I actually recognized something, because, you know, I didn't expect to recognize anything in Thailand. I've never been there before. But I looked close, and based on their behavior and what they were doing, I knew that those were weaver ants.
What's so exciting about weaver ants?
So what makes weaver ants so unique is their behavior of nest building. So what they do is a highly cooperative behavior where they build nests in trees using silk. And you might think, well, I didn't know that ants made silk. Well, adult ants don't make silk, they can't. Only the larvae can make silk. So in weaver ants, the adults use the larvae as a tool to build their nest. It's totally incredible. The larvae have evolved to be passive dispersers of silk. The adults pick them up and they carry them in their jaws and they move them to a leaf and then they tap them with their antennae, and then that's the signal for the larvae to excrete silk. They attach it to a leaf and they move it to another leaf, and then they tap it with their antennae in a very specific way again, and then it releases the silk. And then it does that ritualistic behavior again and again until the leaves are stitched together.
Could you tell us more about their nest building behavior?
Weaver ant nest building involves two incredibly complicated and coordinated behaviors. The first is the process of bringing the leaves together to form the nest. Weaver ant nests are formed in trees out of leaves that are brought together in a basket of sorts that they live inside and they have their eggs and larvae in. To pull those leaves together, they often have to form a chain of ants that string from one leaf to the other to then ratchet it closed. So imagine like a barrel of monkeys that are connecting two different leaves and pulling it together. This is where the second coordinated behavior comes in, which is then attaching those leaves, weaving them together once they're close to each other. There are only two species of weaver ants, both in the genus Oecophylla. One that lives in Africa and another that lives in Southeast Asia and Australia. Now, the idea of weaving with silk is not unique among weaver ants. There are other ants that do that. And weaving with silk has evolved four times in ants. But the full complex suite of behaviors are unique among the genus Oecophylla.
How did weaver ants evolve this ability to use silk as a tool?
The use of silk by weaver ants is a great example of neo-functionalization. This is where a trait that served one purpose evolves to serve a completely different purpose. A good example of this is feathers in birds. When feathers first evolved, it's thought that their primary function was to keep birds warm, but of course later feathers also were used to aid in flight. Silk in ants, as well as most other insects, is used in the process of metamorphosis. When a larva reaches the end of its development, it wraps itself up in silk to form a pupa. Inside that pupa, metamorphosis occurs and then an adult emerges. In weaver ants, the silk is used for a completely new purpose, which is building their nest. To do this, they had to evolve several unique traits. The first is to have really huge silk glands that produce way more silk than other ants would. And the second is that they evolved to produce silk earlier on in development, which gives them more time to aid in the nest building process.
Do they have any benefits for humans?
Farmers have been using weaver ants to control pests on their crops for over 1700 years, which is the oldest example of biocontrol. Now, modern day farmers of cocoa, citrus, coconut, mangoes, and cashew encourage weaver ants in their orchards, which help control the pests. So next time you eat chocolate or mangoes, you might have a weaver ant to thank. But in addition to controlling the pests, they are also a food source in themselves. The larvae of weaver ants are eaten as a delicacy, particularly in Thailand. So in addition to improving the yield of those crops, they're also an extra protein source on their own.
That's our Weaver Ant episode for you. Thanks for watching. We hope you found it as interesting as we did. Now you know what those balls of leaves are if you ever see one out and about. We'll be back with more episodes, so subscribe if you want to keep updated. Now here's Leslie Nielsen hosting a 1970s nature documentary about animals that use tools, featuring one and only weaver ants.
As with any other highly organized project, there is a division of labor. Some do the holding and others do the weaving. Soon the ants have built a firm and dense connection between the leaves, using their own larvae as their tools.